first ever guitar tutorial video. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to play my favourite song from the Weeknd Starboy album called Sidewalks. Why is it my favourite song? There's only one reason, because Kendrick Lamar absolutely kills it with his verse, and it's got a really prominent guitar riff to it as well. So in this video, as you saw in the preview, I'm going to be showing you how to play the song in four parts. So the first part, I'm going to be showing you how to play the riff that starts at the beginning and repeats itself throughout the rest of the song. I'm then going to be showing you how to play the backing track and the backing chords. Then I'm going to be showing you how to play the melody for the chorus, and then I'm going to recreate the beat on the guitar and then tie it all together into one soundbite and see what it sounds like. So I'll leave the tabs in the description below to help, but if you have any questions, please just leave a comment below and I'll answer them as soon as I can. But before we do kick off, please give this video a thumbs up if you think it helps, and check out my other guitar covers on my channel. I did do a cover of this the song Starboy, and I'm happy to put a tutorial video together to show you how to play it, along with any of the other songs on my channel. So without any further ado, alright, so let's start with the riff. I'm going to play it twice and then I'm going to break it into little parts. It goes something like this. So let me beat this down to little parts. So what we do is we start on the 7th fret of the B string, then we go to the 5th fret of the E string, then the 7th fret of the E string, and then the 9th fret of the E string. So let me play that little part. Then what we do is go from the 9th fret of the E string, back to the 7th fret of the E string, we pull off from the 7th fret of the E string to the 5th fret, then back to the 7th fret, and then back to the 9th fret. So I'll play that little part again as well. Now combining the part 1 with part 2, it goes something like this. After that bit, put our first finger on the 5th fret of the E string. We then hammer on the 3rd finger onto the 7th fret of the E string, so we go, and then we pull off on the 5th fret. Alright, so like this. And then we go back to the 4th fret of the E string. So it goes like this. Combining part 1, part 2 and part 3 together, it goes something like this. So then what we do is we go on the 2nd fret of the E string. We then hammer on the 4th fret. And then pull off on the 2nd fret of the E string, right? So something like this. So combining those parts together. Right? And then the last thing to do is play the 4th fret of the E string and then the 5th fret of the E string. So combine that all together slowly and get something like this. So that's the first half of the riff. The second half of the riff is this. You put your 3rd finger on the 7th fret of the B string. Then you put your 1st finger on the 5th fret of the E string. And then your 3rd finger on the 7th fret of the E string. And then you play the 5th fret again. You hammer onto the 7th fret. So let's play that. You've got to slide quickly to the 9th fret, so now there's two things you could do. Either you can play it simple, so like this, or you can try and mimic what the song does and try and play the 9th fret. And then after the 9th fret, you slide onto the 12th fret and do exactly the same. So either you go like that, or you go, and then you go to the 14th fret. So let's play that second half again. So now I'm going to teach you how to play the backing chord of the track. So we start with a bar chord on the 9th fret. So you want to play the A string first. Then you want to put your second finger on the 10th fret of the B string, and then your third finger on the 11th fret of the G string. Right? So it goes A string, and then you strum down, and you do that twice. So then you go to the 9th fret of the E string, whilst holding the bar on the 9th fret, and you play the 9th fret of the E string, and then you strum down twice. And then you repeat that 3 times, so it goes something like this. So after you've repeated that 3 times, you move down to the 7th fret and then hold a B minor chord, and you strum it down for 8 beats. So it goes something like this. Simple as that. And then once you do that 8 times, you then hold a C sharp minor chord on the 9th fret. So you hold a bar on the 9th fret, and then your 3rd and 4th fingers should go on the 11th fret on the A and D strings, like that. And then you just strum once. Now I'll do the backbone chord sequence again. So for the melody, you want to have your 3rd finger on the B string, 10th fret. So you play that, then you move down your 1st finger to the 7th fret, play it once more, then move your 1st finger down to the 5th fret, then hammer on the 7th fret, and then play the 5th fret again, and then your 2nd finger goes on the G string on the 6th fret. So I'll play that bit again. So after you play the 6th fret on the G string, you then quickly play the 5th fret on the B string, hammer on the 7th, and then back on the 5th fret. So I'll show you that. And then after that, you play the 6th fret on the G string, then the 5th fret on the B string, back to the 6th fret on the G string, and then your 5th fret on the B string, and then hammer on the 7th quickly. So I'll play that a little bit. So let's play the melody from start to finish. And then you repeat that once more. So let's break that down. So you start with the 5th fret on the B string, hammer onto the 7th string, play the 5th fret on the E string, then play the 7th fret on the E string, but quickly slide it to the 9th fret on the E string. So, like that. So I'll do that again. The second bit starts exactly the same way. So you play the 5th fret on the B string, hammer onto the 7th, and then you play the 9th fret on the E string, then the 7th fret on the E string, then play it again, then the 5th fret on the E string, and then the 7th fret on the B string. So I'll do that again. The third bit is exactly the same as the first bit, as you do this, but then you slide again to the 12th fret, and then 12th fret again, then 9th fret, and then slide onto the 5th. So I'll show you that. So that's the third bit, and then the final bit is, so you start off on the B string on fret 5, and you do your normal hammer. Then you go straight to fret 9 on string E, then drop to fret 7 and pluck it twice. Then wait 2 beats and then pluck fret 5 and then fret 9. So I'll just do that again. And then you do your normal hammer again. And then straight to fret 9 on string E. Then fret 7. And then fret 7 on string B. So the whole of the part 4 goes like this. When it comes to B, it's really simple. Just follow what I do. So you do that throughout the whole song. So there's only one variation to that when you play the B minor chord 8 times. The B goes like this to match the 8 beats of the B minor chord, and that's the only variation. I hope you found that tutorial useful. Again, please give me a thumbs up if you found it helpful. And yeah, check out my other covers on my channel and let me know if there's any other tutorial videos you want me to make. And yeah, that's it for me.